Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the 72nd Annual Plainfield Lions Club Creche Lighting Program here at Plymouth Church. I always ask everyone at the beginning of the program, how many people have not ever been here before? Wow, well, Pastor, put your hand down. Well, thank you very much for coming. I hope you enjoy the program. And for everybody who's been here before, welcome back. It's good to see a lot of familiar faces. Before we get started, I'd like to acknowledge some of the people that made tonight possible. First of all, I'd like to thank the Plainfield Lions Club and their president, Todd Schnowski, for putting up the creche and for being here tonight. I'd like to thank Pastor Bill and the Plymouth Congregational family for getting the sanctuary decorated and everything organized for the evening. I would like to thank Christian Larios and the Plainfield North Madrigals for coming to sing for us tonight. I would like to thank our readers, Mike Burns, Christy Brand, Bob Zirko, and Beth Kaiser. And I would also like to thank Mr. Brendan Kaiser, who is the Director of Instrumental Music at Winchester High School in Indiana, for coming to play the trumpet tonight. And this is my 35th year doing this, my 35th year as organist here, and it's just been the most wonderful blessing to do this every year and to have everybody here and singing, and it's just wonderful. So let's get started with the Christmas carols. We're going to sing the first three in a row. Just give me time to turn pages in between the pieces.
Thank you.
The next song, Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire, is one of the most recorded songs of all the Christmas songs that there is. It's been recorded, it's been played by everybody, sung by everybody. It's just a wonderful song. And if you didn't know, it was written by Mel Torme. So let's join and sing that one. Okay, everybody take out your keys. Keys, because we have to have jingle bells for jingle bells. Okay, so when we get to the chorus, jingle your keys, and I don't want to have to stop and tell you twice to holler, hey.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you for coming. I'm Bill Beagle. I happen to be the pastor here. Praise the Lord. And this is my 15th creche lighting. Hallelujah. And it's been different every year. And I'm so grateful for those who put this together. I just came today and helped. But it's such a unique sight to see everybody put everything together and do it so quickly and efficiently. But I'm thankful to the Lions Club for their participation in this for 72 years. And I'm even more grateful that they stuck with us for the past 15 years, because I sometimes get a little difficult, huh, Bob? Not really. But I thank you for coming, and enjoy the evening. And we will, there is a box on the table in the narthex. It's got a green cover on top of it. And all the offering that we take tonight goes to the Plainfield Interfaith Food Pantry. And so we are privileged and pleased to join with them to help feed those who need that assistance. And years past, we donated to the Ministerial Association, but now they seem to be doing fairly well as far as finances are concerned. And we turned our vision to the Interfaith Food Pantry. So anything that you give tonight will go to the Interfaith Food Pantry. If you're making a checkout, make it out to the Plainfield Interfaith Food Pantry. If you happen to make it out to Plymouth, our treasurer Beth will take care of that. But please, please give generously, because this is the time of year that we need to help folks that are a little less fortunate than we are. And I'm so thankful that I happen to be on the plus side of that line. And this is the 72nd year of this particular celebration. And so it started when I was 5 years old. So we're grateful to be a part of it. And we're thankful to be here in Plainfield and have been here for such a good long time. And we pray that you folks will continue to enjoy this celebration and have a good time tonight. And sing very loud, will you? We'll see if we can. I know we can't, but we'll try to sing louder than these two. Good luck. And thank you, Brendan. Appreciate you being here, and thank you, Jan. Thank you, everybody that's put it together. God bless you.
Hello. How am I doing, Sam? Lion Sam. So good evening, everybody. November 25th, yeah, good evening, everyone. Beautiful night. I am Lion Tachinowski, and welcome to the 72nd annual of the Lions Creche Lighting Program. So I've done this speech a lot over the years, probably starting in 16, quite a few times. I've said about everything that I could say about the Plainfield Lions Creche, all our Plainfield service endeavors, all our charitable work we do in our community, and this wonderful ceremony at the Plymouth Church. This year, I'm going to talk about traditions. So when you think about traditions, you can think on a grand scale, such as cultural faith-based traditions, or you can think of something more family-specific, so like making rice pudding for the holidays. So my father, Harley, loved his rice pudding so much, he made it every year himself over the course of hours and days, taste-testing it over and over and getting it chilled to perfection. Harley was a rice pudding snob. So, Harley's not with us anymore, but when folks think about traditions, whether it's Christmas, something specific to a community, or a family custom passed down over generations, traditions make us feel good. They make you smile like Harley's rice pudding. They make you feel warm inside, and they give you hope. That's how I feel every year when I set up our Plainfield Lions Creche and I attend this ceremony that night. If Will Ferrell was here, he would say, I don't know another community that has a life-size baby Jesus scene. You remember Talladega Nights? Yeah, anyway, so I kind of think of myself as a slightly better-looking Will Ferrell. So all joking aside, our Lions Creche ceremony at the gorgeous Plymouth Church is just a magnificently awesome tradition in our Plainfield community. Thank you for everybody attending tonight. Enjoy the evening. Yeah, thank you.
Our first reading is Mary's angelic visitation from Luke 1, 26 through 38. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled in his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come to you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." And then the angel left her.
Thank you. The second reading, Joseph's angelic visitation, Matthew 1:18-25. This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was faithful to the law and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us."
Masters in this hall, hear ye all the news today, brought from oversea, pray, hear ye what I say.
No, sing me clear, hope in all folk on earth, born the Son of God so dear. No, sing me loud, God's your day hath formed and raised it up and cast it down the proud.
No. nobis Domine tua gloria, no 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 nobis Domine tua gloria. No, no, Domine, 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 tua gloria. No, no, Domine,
Our third reading is the Shepherd's Angelic Vision, which comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 20. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior is born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby
who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Our final reading tonight is from the book of Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Thank you. do dinner anymore, but we still do a madrigal concert. So there's a lot of music and singing and holiday fun. There's also a lot of comedy. And you can really see the students' personalities shine. And so this year our shows are on December 8th and 9th at Plainfield North High School. They're at 7 p.m. And they're kind of, they are give what you can. So if you're able to give some money at the door, that's awesome. But if you're unable to, that's also fine as well. So all are welcome to come to our madrigal concerts on December 8th and 9th at 7 p.m. Our last two songs, our first one is called Northern Lights. This is a tune our choir program just really loves to sing and perform. It's kind of a story about friendship and forgiveness. And then our last tune is an arrangement of Angels We've Heard on High. Thank you so much for having us tonight.
Played again.
Please don't forget the Interfaith Food Pantry offering tonight. And I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. And if you didn't, you need to get your blesser fixed. So it was very, very good. And all of our music is good. I want to thank Jan for doing all the hard work. She put the bulletin and readers and everything together. All I had to do tonight was show up. I want to thank Bob for printing everything, and I want to thank the readers. It's amazing when I step back and other people begin to do things. And it's hard sometimes for me to do that, but I'm learning. After 53 years of doing this, I'm learning how to let other people lead. But they've done a great job, and our readers tonight did an especially good job. And you guys are to be applauded for coming out tonight. Thank you very much. And for our last song, before we do that, I'd like to have a benediction. I'd like for you to stand. And when we get finished with the song, we get to the third verse, we leave. All the directions are in here. Okay. Follow the directions. Stand with me as we pray together, would you please? If you can. If you can't, that's okay. Stay seated. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for the Advent season that we're approaching. And God, we thank you for the Lions Club and their wonderful generosity in sharing their gift with us and with the village. And Father, we thank you for the Village Fathers who have allowed us to do this for the past 72 years. And God, though political climates change and everything looks different, God, we know one thing remains the same, and that's you. And our celebration tonight is one of joy and festivity. And God, the anticipation of the celebration of the birth of Christ, for which we give you thanks. And Lord, we thank you that you are Emmanuel, God with us. Lord, as we proceed from here out to finish the service outside, we simply ask that the presence of your Holy Spirit would continue there. And God, that we would always be reminded when we pass this corner to look and see what you did for us on that cold morning in Bethlehem, where you became flesh. And God, we thank you for your gift of salvation through Jesus Christ. Now bless each one, guide and direct us as we sing our last song and get ready to go outside. And Father, we pray that the lighting of this creche this year would be especially wonderful. For God, we ask your presence to be here. And we pray in Jesus' name, and all God's children said, amen. Amen. Thank you.